Today we are going to study about composition of two SHMs having same peak. Composition means what? Till now you have studied about just one wave which is moving in one direction. Now what will happen if two waves are simultaneously moving in one dimension along the same path? Then what is the resultant displacement going to be? We have two SHMs which are having same period. We have to see what the resultant is going to be, whether it is a simple harmonic motion also or it may not be also. We will just check what resultant we are going to get when two simple harmonic motions are present in the same medium along the same path and having the same period. Okay, now you know the equation for simple harmonic motion, that is x is equal to a sine omega t plus phi. Okay, I want to consider two simple harmonic motions, so I'll consider one more, a sine omega t plus phi. Now what we are going to do is we are just going to keep the period same. Period means what? Capital T. Now amplitude is going to be different, so I'll take a1 and a2 for these two different waves. Also the initial phase is going to be different, so I'll take phi1 and phi2. What should I do about this omega? Omega is the angular velocity, and you know the formula for omega is 2 pi by capital T. If T is remaining same, that is period is remaining same, then omega is also going to remain the same. So I'm not going to write omega 1 and omega 2. I'm just going to keep it as omega. Now if A1, A2 is changing, phi1 and phi2 are changing, we are not going to get the same displacement. We are going to get it as x1 and x2. So these are the two equations of two simple harmonic motions having same period along the same path. Both are moving along the same path. We want to check what the resultant is going to be. Okay? So let me take the resultant as x. The resultant displacement of a particle with time t is x. So this x is going to be what? It will be a resultant of these two simple harmonic motions. They are along the same line, along the same path. So I can just add it, x1 plus x2. If they would have been in different directions, then I would have taken the vector conditions into consideration. But they are along the same path, so it's just going to be an algebraic addition, right? X1 plus x2. That will give me the resultant displacement of a particle. Now we just have to put the equations and see what we get. Okay? So I'll substitute for x1. X1 is a1 sine omega t plus phi1, and x2 is a2 sine omega t plus phi. Okay? We will solve for this sine, we will expand it. What do we get? A1 sin omega t cos phi 1 plus a1 cos omega t sin of phi 1. Okay, you know sin of a plus b is sin a cos b plus cos a sin b. So I will use the same thing to solve this one. Now I will expand this one, this bracket. So I will get a2 sin omega t cos of phi 2 plus a2 cos omega t sin of phi 2. Okay? Now see these terms. In this I am going to take sin omega t common, and here I will take cos omega t common. A1, A2, phi 1, phi 2 are all constants. They are not going to change. The maximum amplitude, the epoch or the initial phase is not going to change. What is changing is only this t. T will change, and along with this t, x will change. So I will take the t terms common and keep the other terms within the bracket. So what do I get? I will get this as, I'll combine these two terms, take sin omega t common. So I'll get a1 cos of phi 1 plus a2 cos phi 2 sin omega t comes out. So sin omega t plus a1 sin phi 1 plus a2 sin phi 2 and cos omega t comes out. Okay, now we will see further how to solve this. So this is the equation that we had got. X is equal to a1 cos phi 1, a2 cos phi 2 sin omega t and plus bracket into cos omega t. Okay, so now these are all constants which we have put in bracket. So we will substitute some suitable other constant over there. So I'll choose R cos delta to be a1 cos phi 1 plus a2 cos phi 2. Okay, in place of this bracket I have put R cos delta. Sin omega t will come as it is. So sin omega t plus, in place of this bracket, a1 sin phi 1, a2 cos sin phi 2, I will put R sin delta. Since sin sin terms are there, I have taken R sin delta. And since cos cos is there, I have taken cos delta. Okay? And cos omega t comes as it is. So this is the equation that we have got. Can we simplify it further? Yes, we can simplify it further. I will get it as R sin of omega t plus delta. So see, this is the resultant displacement that we are getting. R is the amplitude of this resultant motion. Sin of omega t plus delta. Delta is the initial phase of this resultant motion. This R and delta are constants because we have taken this from some constant term. Okay, delta and R are based on this constant terms. So R and delta are constants. And what is the time period? See, omega. Omega is the angular velocity. So time period T is going to remain same as what we had earlier. These were our two earlier equations of simple harmonic motion. We have got the resultant of this as X is equal to R sin omega t plus delta. See, it is in the same form. So the resultant is also a simple harmonic motion. Amplitude is changing. Initial phase is changing. But see this omega t, omega t, omega t. That means what? For the new waveform, the period is remaining the same. The period remains the same. Amplitude and initial phase is changing, but the period remains the same and it is a simple harmonic motion. That is what we have proved. Now we will see how to find this R and delta. Now we will find the value of R. We had the equation R cos delta is a1 cos phi 1 plus a2 cos phi 2. R sin delta is a1 sin phi 1 plus a2 sin phi 2. So if I want to find R, what is the best way to do it? I'll just square and add this, because we know that sin square plus cos square is 1, right? So I'll add square these two equations and add them. Okay, so I have written it directly: R square cos square delta plus R square sin square delta. Okay, I have squared and added the left hand side, and here I have squared and added the right hand side. So square of this term, a1 cos phi 1 plus a2 cos phi 2, I have squared a1 cos square phi 1 plus a2 cos square phi 2 plus 2a1 a2 cos phi 1 cos phi 2. And squaring this term, a1 square sin square phi 1 plus a2 square sin square phi 2 plus 2a1 a2 sin phi 1 sin phi 2. Okay, now we will add these two terms. Now when you are adding, you will see that here we have cos square phi 1 and sin square phi 1. a1 square will come out and you will have cos square phi 1 and sin square phi 1, which is 1. So when you add these two terms, you will just get a1 square. Same way over here. If you take a2 square common, you will have cos square phi 2 and sin. a1, so you will just have a2 square because we had taken it common, right? So a2 square. Now these two terms, from these two terms I can take 2a1 a2 common, so 2a1 a2, and I will have cos phi 1 cos phi 2 plus sin phi 1 sin phi 2. Okay, so what is the formula for that? Cos of phi 1 minus phi 2. You know that cos of a minus b is cos a cos b plus sin a sin b. So using that rule, I have got this equation. What is it equal to? R square, because sin square delta plus cos square delta is also 1. So R square is equal to this. So R, that is our new amplitude of the new motion, simple harmonic motion, is square root of a1 square plus a2 square plus 2a1 a2 cos phi 1 minus phi 2. See, it is a constant. It is not changing with time because there is no time term. Now we will see how to find delta. To find delta, I don't want this r. I want the r to get cancelled. So what we have done, we will take ratio of those two equations. So r sin delta upon r cos delta. So that this r and r will get cancelled. Okay? So sin delta upon cos delta, I will get tan delta. R sin delta was what? a1 sin phi 1 plus a2 sin phi 2. And cos delta was a1 cos phi 1 plus a2 cos phi 2. So this upon this. So tan delta is this entire bracket. What will delta be equal to? I can just write delta is equal to tan inverse of this. Again see, these are all constant terms. So delta is also not going to change, it is remaining constant. Now we will see the special cases. Special cases. Now this was the equation for R that we had got. R is equal to square root of a1 square plus a2 square plus 2a1 a2 cos phi 1 minus phi 2. Now we will see what happens if this phi 1 minus phi 2 is 0. That means the difference between this is 0. Means what? The two waves are start having the same initial phase. They are starting with the same initial phase, these two waves. Then what will be the resultant amplitude? That's what we are going to see. So when phi 1 minus phi 2 is 0, we will substitute 0 over here. Cos 0 is 1. So I will get R is equal to a1 square plus a2 square plus 2a1 a2. This is nothing but a1 plus a2 square and square root of that. So a1 plus a2. R is equal to a1 plus a2. Resultant amplitude is addition of these two if the phase difference is 0. Moreover, you can see that if a1 equal to a2 you have, then R will be equal to 2 times a. R will be 2 times a. Okay, so this is the first case. See the second case, phi 1 minus phi 2 is 90 degrees. That means the difference, the phase difference between the two waves is 90 degrees. Okay, in this case what will happen? Phi 1 minus phi 2 is 90, cos 90 is 0. So this term will become 0 and we will get R is equal to root of a1 square plus a2 square. Again, if a1 is equal to a2, you will get R is equal to 2 times a1 square, so root of 2a. Okay. The third case, phi 1 minus phi 2 is equal to 180 degrees. That means the phase difference is 180 degrees. They are totally out of phase. Okay. You now know what is phase difference and what is phase. So phase difference is 180 degrees. So cos 180 is minus 1. So I get the equation R is equal to square root of a1 square plus a2 square plus 2a1 a2 into minus 1. So it becomes root of a1 minus a2 square. Okay. So R is equal to a1 minus a2. We have put it in the modulus sign because we just want the distance. It can happen that a1 is less than a2, then you will get the negative sign. But we don't want the negative sign, so we have put modulus. Okay. And again here also, if a1 is equal to a2, R will be equal to 0 because we have a1 minus a2. Okay? So these are the three special cases. What have we seen? When two waves are adding up, the resultant is also a simple harmonic motion with the same period. Thank you.